Hare Krishna. Everything is not in the mind, but everything comes through the mind. Now, some people often undervalue or underestimate the power of the mind, and some people overestimate its power. So some people say that whatever is in the mind doesn't matter, only the physical reality matters. And if life is tough, it's tough. And some people say actually all problems are in the mind. There is, if you think there is no problem, then there is no problem. Now this is not reality. Neither of these two extremes are the reality. Everything is not in the mind. There is a physical reality, and we have to deal with the physical reality in physically appropriate ways. So if there is a wall in front of me, and if I think there is no wall, that the wall is just in my mind, and I walk into the wall, I'll bang my head. So everything is not in the mind, in the sense that everything is not just a mental construct. There are physical realities also out there. Having said that, everything comes through us, comes to us through the mind. So if we consider the physical reality is here, the mind is here, and then we, the conscious observer, the soul, are here. So we don't connect with the physical reality directly. It is only through our mind and the mental constructions present therein, is through them that we perceive the physical reality. And that's why it's important for each one of us to know that the mind plays a pivotal role in shaping our perception of reality. And why is understanding this important? Because whenever we consider that, suppose the mind is troubling, suppose we are feeling troubled by some situation. Now, we are experiencing that situation through our mind. And that means that if we can change our perception of that situation, then we can put ourselves at relatively lesser distress. So for example, somebody has insulted us. Now, if we have a vengeful program in the mind, then we will be burning with revenge fantasies for a long, long time. Or if we have a self-pity program in the mind, then we will start thinking, oh, everybody keeps trampling over me. Life is terrible. And people are horrible. And I am worthless. And again, that will hurt us much, much more. So if we understand that everything comes to us through the mind, then we can observe our mind and understand how our mind tends to filter the way, to filter and distort the way we perceive things. And then we can correct those perceptions as is appropriate. So that would mean that we work diligently to distance ourselves from the mind and to evaluate the mind before we evaluate what the mind, what is being shown by the mind. So Krishna recommends this in 6.5 in the Bhagavad-Gītā, when he states, Uddhare dātmanātmānam nātmānam avisādayet ātmai vaya ātmano bandhur ātmaiva ripurātmanaha. So he says, Uddhare dātmanātmānam. He says, elevate yourself with your mind. One ātmā means here, of course, the soul. Other ātmā can be said referred to the mind. So elevate yourself with your mind. That means, look at your mind in a way that helps you to take to act constructively. Natmanam avisadayet. Don't act in the way that is destructive. Atmaivaya atmano bandhur. Atmaiva ripuratmanaha. Thus that your mind can be your friend and it can be your enemy also. So knowing these, act carefully, act responsibly. So the balanced middle ground between overestimating the mind, considering that everything is in the mind, and the underestimating the mind, considering that, believing that everything is a physical reality, is that everything comes through the mind. And when the mind processes things unhealthily, destructively, then it hurts us. And when we can reprogram our mind through purification and through intelligent processing, then We can pursue things in a way that is constructive, and thus we can create a better life for ourselves. Thank you. Hare Krishna.